alayhi wa sallam. This is Sahih in Muslim. And this is the easiest way for shaitan to misguide a person towards shirk. This is the most easiest way. And there are many proof for this, as you will see also in Surah Jinn, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrates the whole story, that the jinns, they are saying that before we used to have seats in the heavens, and we used to get the knowledge of the unseen by sitting over there, by hearing the malaika. But then something happened, and when we go over there, our seats are removed. And if we try to go over there, we are hated by meteors. By the, you can see the broken star, as you see many a times, that a star will break and the stone will go like this. And some people, they even do bid'ah in this. They say, oh, broken star, make dua. No, this is a custom of the Hindus. This is a custom of Mushrik. This is not the custom of a Muslim. This is not the way of a Muslim. That is, the star has only three purposes, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that the stars have only three purposes. If anyone is trying to find a fourth, he is misguided. One, to show you the way. For the people who are on the seas, they look at the stars and they find the way, okay, where is such and such country. Number two, the beautification of the heaven. And number three, to hit the jinnah, to hit the devil, the shayateen. One last thing is, from the meditation point of view, you will see many people, whenever they will get sick or something will happen to them, they rush towards the doctor. But the act of a Muslim should be that your first thing is something on which you are judged. If something bad happens, especially the women, they do like this, our mothers or our sisters, you will see them, what happened? Okay, they would get worried and they would do like this. But rather, what is the way of Muslim? What should we say? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allahumma ajirni fi musibati wa akhli fi khairu minha. Now let's go to the doctor. Why? Because whatever is in the qadr, whatever pain, whatever difficult time that is written, you cannot change it. And your confusion, you're being confused, you're taking stress on yourself, you're taking tension on yourself, will not change the situation. Rather, it will make it worse. How? For example, I have a brother. My brother, he falls from the roof and he breaks his head. Now I get afraid and I turn into the car and I'm rushing in the car. How many percent chances are there that I will get hit myself? I will have an accident also because I'm rushing and not thinking anything else except that, go to the doctor. There is a big chance that I will hit, that I will get an accident, and then not only my mother, but I will also get injured. And what if I say, Ya Allah help me, and I say, no, let me take you to the doctor. I remain calm. In the way I ask, I'm making dua, Ya Allah cure him, Ya Allah cure him, Ya Allah help him. And then I reach the hospital. I go in a peaceful, calm way because I know whatever is written, it will happen. But I'm doing the means, which is to go towards the doctor and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the way. Now what is better? The first way or the second way? The second way. So your first action is that on which you are judged. So try to be calm. If anything happens, be calm. Don't get afraid. Don't get stressed. Don't take tension. But always remember, Allah is there. Allah knows what is happening. It has been created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so be pleased with it. Now there are two stories that I will say and then it will finish. This is a story that I heard from the same scholar. He said, once a person came to me. He had an 8-month-old baby in his hand. 8-month-old baby. When he came over there, the father, he said, the baby fell down. He said, I looked at the baby, I looked at the head, the baby was crying and crying and crying. I look at the head, I look at the ears, everything was okay. I said, your baby is fine. He said, no, it fell down. He said, okay, maybe it fell down from the bed. He said, no, it fell down, it fell down. And he was doing like this, pointing forth. He said, what forth? He said, it fell down from the fourth floor of my building. From the fourth floor of my building, it fell down. My wife was carrying it. and the baby just fell off from the fourth floor. You can imagine from the top of this CL cafe. From this floor she fell down. So when I heard this, I looked at the baby with surprise. 8-month-old baby? And I said, it fell on the head. Nothing happened. No bone is broken. He's alive. He said, I kept the baby over there for 10 hours to see. And the baby was fine. What is this? What does it show to us? That death and life is in the hand of who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah wants to save, He can save a baby who is falling off from the fourth floor. And a few days ago I was reading on the newspaper, the Arab news, when I was there in Saudi Arabia, a small girl who was 11 years old, she fell down from the 10th floor on a car. And the car, the front window and the back window broken, and the top of the car was inside. It went inside. And when she fell down, she just got up and went back. Subhanallah. And they were showing the picture. It was a black color car and the roof was inside. And the window was broken. And the child was just standing and smiling. Subhanallah. From the 10th floor. So remember this, death and life in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. Another story he said, when he was in the medical college, he was young. He said there were two friends of ours. They were riding a motorbike. Now the friend who was riding the bike, he just, rushed the bike, just for fun. You know, they were young and they had this passion, riding fast and blah, blah, blah. So he just accelerated the bike. So when he did, the person who was sitting on the back of the bike, he fell down. When he fell down, he died. Now look, a child from the fourth floor and a young, healthy guy. From how much height? This much height maybe? A few meters? One or two meters? And he died. So remember this thing, that death and life is in the hands of Allah Ta'ala alone. If anything happens, just say inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allahumma ajurni fi musibati wa akhri bi khair minha. Then if you can, make wudu, pray 2 rakat salah, and then go to the doctor. The first thing is, whenever you get sick, even if you get injured, even if you break your hand, you break your leg, first thing, Ya Allah help me, Ya Allah cure me, you are the one who cured. Then go to the doctor. And on the way, make dua, Ya Allah help me, Ya Allah help me. Make tasbihat. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His beautiful name. Because doctor is nothing. So what can the doctor do? Do you think the doctor has the power to cure you? Or do you think they control your heartbeat or they control your blood? No, they don't. What will they do? They will give you a medication that will maybe increase or decrease the blood flow. They will give you a medication that will maybe increase or decrease the blood circulation, blood formulation. Nothing else. They do not give you life and they do not give you death. It is only in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all follow the right aqidah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all have the correct belief, the belief that should be of a Muslim. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all follow Islam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all believe in Him as He should be believed. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds and forgive our sins. Ameen. Ya Arshmar Rahimeen. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala shaykh al-anbiya wa muslimin. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Thank you.